Welcome to the national final of the Rotary's Young Chef 2010. In preparation for their three-course dishes a bit later, the contestants have to lay their places. There are points available for their attention to detail, and these points are added to their final scores overall. So while they make their preparations, let's meet each one in turn and find out about their menus and what they are hoping to do that will catch the eye of the judges.
For starter, I'm doing gâteau of local crab with wasabi potato salad and creme fraiche. And then for main course, I'm doing roulade of chicken breast with potato rosti, wild mushroom and griddled spring onions. And then I'm doing lavender rice pudding with vanilla poached pear and twill biscuits.
I'm cooking a tea smoked duck with a mozzarella and orange salad, herb crusted cod on pre-lentils with tempura prawns, rhubarb and custard tart with stone ginger ice cream.
For my starter, I'm going to be doing a tomato and cumin soup with an aubergine caviar. For my main course, I'm going to be doing a garlic and rosemary infused loin of lamb, served with spinach and mint, a butternut squash puree, fondant potatoes, glazed carrots and a red currant jus. And for my dessert, I'm going to be doing a rhubarb assiette, which will have a mini rhubarb crumble tartlet, a vanilla panna cotta and stacked sticks of rhubarb.
I'm starting with Canadian chive ravioli with red chard and a roast beetroot dressing. And then my main one is a loin of venison with millefeuille potatoes, carrot and swede and red wine juice. And my dessert is pear tart tatin with mascarpone cream.
Starter is honey pepper pear with goat's cheese. For main, it is rolled stuffed scalloped turkey with a celeriac spring roll and fondant potatoes. And for pudding is treacle tart, lemon curd ice cream and Langdon nuts.
Miso glazed salmon with the Thai cucumber salad. And then lemon and thyme crusted chicken bake with some broccoli. And then a down high mess, which is a version of meringues, cream and berries.
For my starter, I've got seared scallops on a green bean and mange tout salad with a tomato sorbet. And then for my main, I've got herb crusted rack of lamb with pomna, braised baby onions, sweet baby carrots, and a lamb rosemary jus. And then for my dessert, I've got a mini layered summer pudding with fresh fruit and chantilly.
So with their places set, and whilst Giovanni Fontebasso, the competition referee, explains the rules to the contestants, let's meet the judges.
I'm here today to judge the competition, and we're looking for somebody who is very confident and has a very interesting meal.
Well, I'll be looking for well thought out, seasonally prepared meals and well presented.
I mean, what's really important is the flavour that these young chefs can bring out, because they all, we've seen, have very challenging menus, but I think it's the execution and flavour that is the most important thing.
For innovation, colour, texture, flavours, and also some inspiration from the competitor themselves.
Judges enter and the cooking begins. The contestants have exactly 2 hours to prepare and cook their three courses. Eight sets of nervous families and friends wait patiently while the competition continues. The Rotary Club have laid on a marquee, a hog roast and drinks. Back in the kitchen, things are hotting up. contestants are required to provide two dishes of each item from their menu, one for the table and one for the judges to taste. Dishes are timed as in a real-life situation. The three courses will follow each other, rather than be ready all at the same time. As dishes become cooked and ready, they are tasted by the judges and marked accordingly. Outside of the marquee while the judges confer. While the judges confer, let's have a word with the contestants once more and start by asking how they thought they did.
It went okay. I had a couple of slip-ups, but I've done the best that I could in the time limit, so we can just hope for the best, really.
I think it went okay, yeah. There was a lot of pressure on in the kitchen.
It went really well. It's the best I've ever done it, so I'm glad for that.
It was good, but I still think there's a few things which I could have done better, but I'm always criticising myself.
I think it went all good, hopefully. Fingers crossed.
Alright, I think. There wasn't too many bad mistakes.
I think it went very well.
I think it went okay, actually. Better than I expected it to.
Get my chicken dish out of the cutters and it was starting to collapse a wee bit, but I got it sorted.
My rhubarb at one point, I was like, ah! Had to get it out, but I got it out in time. So it was a
clock and I was like, oh my god, I have 45 minutes left. But I got through it.
Finger a bit of it, so. But apart from that, everything was good.
At one point, I was about 10 minutes behind, but. By the end, I was actually 10 minutes ahead.
My main, I tried some of the broccoli that I cooked, and I'd been a bit heavy-handed with the salt.
The steam machine broke, so I had to. There was ice in the little button thing, so we had to get a skewer and skewer the ice.
I opened the fridge and smashed someone's pudding glass.
It's on the end. I looked at the clock, and there wasn't much time, and I had quite a lot to do. So from there, I was rushing quite a bit, but it was all fine.
Well, if you did something wrong, they'd be like, for next time or what?
Very helpful, and they liked how I did some of my food, especially using pig's gall for my turkey.
I asked questions what we were doing and stuff like that, which was really good, because we got to explain to them and stuff.
But they did keep coming over and saying, are you okay, is there anything you need to do? So that's good.
Said they would mark me on my better one rather than on the one that shouldn't look very good.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. Daphne and I are absolutely delighted to be here today. And we've really enjoyed this experience, this young chef competition, which, may I say, is the key ingredient in the many youth opportunities competitions that Rotary International in Great Britain and Ireland organise.
The judges have been very impressed. They are there, they can't wait to say something, so I pass it on to them straight away. First, please.
I think the spread of marks between the highest and the lowest was 9, 10, 10. Very, very impressed with the standard of cooking by these young people. For me, there were two dishes that stood out. One was a pan-fried salmon as a starter, and there was a young lady that produced a panna cotta, which I think could be served in Sempinche, which has one Michelin star. It's exactly the same dish. That really is the standard of cooking that we've seen today. So, well done.
Very quickly, I have to concur with what's been said, and probably will be said again.
The standard is very, very high, and it has been very, very difficult. That's why we took so long to differentiate the marks. There was so little in it, we had to really argue the toss. All I can say is that everyone who entered this competition came here on their own merit.
The amount of flavours that everyone managed to pack into their dishes was absolutely phenomenal. And I'd just like to say well done to everybody because the standards were so high and it was so close. It's well done.
The professionalism was just outstanding, and I'm privileged enough to get into quite a lot of Michelin star restaurants on a regular basis into the kitchens, and every single one of you that entered could get into those kitchens in time if you've put enough effort in. You really are, every single one of you, good enough to be in a Michelin star kitchen without doubt, definitely without doubt.
There was 6 points between the eight, so you can imagine. Between the second and third is at 1 point.
And David Fell will present the prizes. So Caitlin Grainger, Bethany Dare, April Partridge, Jack Bowden,
the only man,
Stephanie Jones, Jessica Bates, Rebecca Hall, and finally Catherine Burns. Third place, check for £100, and trophy, Stephanie Jones. In second place, Jack Bowden.
I don't know if they mentioned this is a check for £200.
Caitlin Grainger.
This is a cheque for £250, but also includes a trip to Italy to visit the olive grove. You've done a brilliant job.
Sometimes I pinch myself a mile away. This can't be real, this can't be real. Move faster, can't wait any longer. Gotta do something before she gets away. Do it like a movie, take her by the hand.